Song about you. It's like sitting alone in the saddest poem. I'm missing so much inside, I just can't sleep at night. I miss the family that we used to be before you all left me. Stop telling me I'm not the only one that goes through this. Maybe you could be a little sympathy towards my loss and make me feel towards my loss and make me feel
Take a seat, sweetheart. Take a seat, and I'm so impressed that you're here, coming to the platform.
I know.
I was going for a run the other day while everybody was drinking in St Kilda, the St Kilda Festival, and I saw the great lady on stage.
Yeah, I was there.
Wow.
Yeah, it was good. It was a good show. We had, you know, over 500 people come through the door for St Kilda Festival headlining at Memorial Hall. So,
Tanya, yeah. You're a class act. Such a beautiful soul, and that's probably one of the most beautiful voices I've ever heard. Where did the journey start?
Oh, look, it started when I was about 5, so a long time ago now. I'm 24, so yeah, long time ago. I started an Australian Girls Choir, and then I grew out of that quite fast, and I just wanted to be a solo artist and started doing singing lessons and then was professionally playing by age 15. So
Tanya, our good mate Togsy found an amazing song on YouTube.
So he
called
Stalk Me, is that what you're saying?
I think he does stalks me too. Chandelier, let's have a look.
Gonna fly
party life. One look down, one open my eyes. Keep my glass full until morning light. Cause I'm holding on for tonight.
Tanya, that's just spectacular.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, I'm shocked. I remember learning the guitar, CD, you know, and that's about the extent of it. But I know about the singing, but when did you learn how to use the guitar?
I was taught by a man called Charlie Rook. He was in a band called The Sharp in the 80s, quite young, but not too many lessons. He went off and did some other stuff, but he used to let me go into his bookshop, and he used to give me free lessons in his bookshop, which is really cool.
You must be a very disciplined young lady for such talent, you know, while everyone's out having a great time.
Don't have much of a social life, no.
It takes a lot of time, and you are very dedicated, which means mum and dad would have been very, very dedicated parents.
Yeah, they weren't ever stage parents, though, ever. They always just let me do my own thing, and they never had to push me. I just wanted to do music, and I just love singing, and songwriting's been my number one passion.
Amazing.
So, yeah.
Where are they at the moment, mum and dad?
Mum and dad, they are probably cruising, watching TV, having a wine.
Where do they live?
They live in St Kilda. Yeah.
Do they come along and watch the great
night? They do. They support me, yeah. They support me very much. But none of them play music, so I don't know how they... I don't know where I got my thing.
Besides music, I mean, that's exciting enough. What do you do in your spare time?
I write a lot of songs. I do top lining for other artists or anyone needing, you know, lyrics in their instrumentals. I rehearse a lot. I'm writing constantly to create, you know, my next sound, my next EP, my next song or single. You know, it's nonstop. Or I'm doing interviews with lovely people like you.
Amazing. Most girls, they do the choir and they wag and they don't want to do it. But you just have found this talent and you must have been one of the best in the class. Which school did you go to?
I went to Star of the Sea in...
In Brighton?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah, I did.
I lived about 30 metres from there.
There you go.
It's a small world tonight.
So we go long back then.
Oh, that park. You guys have got that nice park, you know, that big mansion. I used to hide it out in there and have a few UDL cans. But that's amazing, Tanya. So you're in that park, you're singing and you've worked all over Australia.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about the journey and the excitement of it all, of being a professional singer.
Yeah, I mean, these opportunities come up, obviously being a musician and working in the entertainment industry. And, you know, I've just been lucky enough to work with incredible people and, you know, write an EP and top line for people and, you know, open shows and stuff like that. So, yeah, it's all part of the journey.
Oh, Tanya, you're such a beautiful soul. And you've brought out an EP a few months ago. What's that called?
It's called Sonder.
Sonder. I had a good listen to it. It's got some amazing sounds. And that's on, I'm a bit older than
iTunes.
What do you call it?
Spotify. Yes.
It's on iTunes,
Spotify, Bandcamp, and my website as well, tanyageorgemusic.com.au.
Oh, okay, so you've got the website.
Yeah.
But then you get it for free, do you? Or you still pay?
Well, you can go through my website and you can pay whatever you feel like.
Yeah.
It's up to you. And, or you can stream it as well.
And you said you went to the States to do a course. Where can you see the future for the great lady going with such a talent? I mean,
Well, I've just finished recording my next EP and I've actually gone a really interesting direction with it, but I've recorded every single instrument you hear in this next EP is my own vocals. So the drums, the bass.
Tanya, you're beautiful, you're rich and famous. If you're not rich, you can be a multi-millionaire in the next 3 years. We'll certainly promote you
for
the next 10 years. Thank you very much for coming on the platform. You're going to be very successful. Viewers, thank you very much for watching The Platform. I'm Michael Kazilny. Love and best wishes. We'll see you next week. Good night.